Hey, what's up YouTube? So today I'm going to show you guys how to downgrade if you've upgraded to 9.2 back to 9.1. Just to point this out, this is only going to work if Apple is signing the firmware. So that means you can actually technically downgrade to any firmware as long as Apple is actually signing that firmware. Apple normally doesn't sign the firmwares for long after the release, so if you've upgraded, you need to move back down as soon as possible. If the signing window is closed, you will not be able to downgrade. So just throwing that out there from the beginning, just so we don't have any misconceptions. I am on 9.2 using an iPhone 4S here as an example, and I'm going to downgrade this back to a 9.1 version. To do this, we are going to need the 9.1 firmware for the device that we're going to downgrade to. So what I want to do is show you guys this website, which I'm going to recommend. Links will be in the description below if you guys need to find this site. And if you want to know what you can downgrade to, you simply just want to head over to the header here. This is on the main homepage, by the way. It's just a Christmas theme, so it may change in the future. Go to Signed Firmwares. Now, find your device in the list. Remember, if you have a GSM or a CDMA, make sure you choose the right variation. I have an iPhone 4S that I'm looking at currently. This will work for any device. So you can see here, Apple is currently signing a 9.1 and 9.2 firmware. These are the current available. It even gives you the signing process, and to download them, just click right here. Once that's complete, you'll have them in the downloads folder here. This is important. You need to have the firmware saved locally, so make sure that they're in your downloads folder or wherever, desktop, doesn't really matter. What you're going to want to do, plug in your device to iTunes. Make sure you have the latest version of iTunes. I am on a Macintosh, so you would open up App Store and do your updates. If you're on Windows, go to the Start Orb, head into the Apple software updates, and then complete those so that you're on the latest version. That should save you some headaches. As for the device, if you want to downgrade this, you will need to turn Find My iPhone off. If you already have it on, I would suggest just signing out of the iCloud account. So here you can see I just don't have anything signed in. And we're going to begin. What you want to do is hold the Option key if you're on a Mac. If you're on Windows, you hold the Shift key, I believe it is. So on the Option key, and you want to click Restore. So while holding the Option key, it's very important because you're going to want to get this to open up. If you click this without clicking the right thing, it's going to hang, and then it's going to ask, do you want to restore this? So no. What you want to do is hit the Alt tab or Shift in the Windows case, hit Restore, and now find your firmware. So I want to downgrade to 9.1. I don't want to go up to 9.2. So I have both of them here. I'm going to show you guys 9.1. Hit Open, and it's going to ask, do you want to restore your device? Click Yes. This process now will take a little bit of time. I will probably pause the video just to not waste your guys' time, and I'll show you the device will actually now perform a full downgrade. At this point, you can go for a coffee, chill out, do whatever you'd like. There's no need to touch, deal with the device. It'll just perform the downgrade all on its own. So we'll be back in a few minutes. This process can take a little bit of time too, so just fair warning, let it do its thing. Alright guys, so we're back here now with 9.1 restored, and I can hit, it's even telling me if I'd like to update my carrier, set up as a new device, perfect, and we will see we're back on 9.1. So that is how you go back. It's not really a magic trick, there's no exploits or anything else like that, so that's all you guys really have to do to restore back to 9.1, which we'll see my version number is now 9.1. My build is 13B143, which is the final version, not a beta, and you can see here I gotta go through the setup process again on the device. So thanks for watching guys, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel for more videos, and we'll see you again next time. Cheers.